when I got on the ground, for me, I hate being boring. Rematch. I always want to come out there and kind of do damage, but what he did was, he did enough to kind of stall what I was doing out, so I felt like I was being a little bit, not over-cautious, not over-patient, but I wanted more action, so I thought, if you don't give me the strikes, I'll strangle you, and that's what I did. I went to one kind of modified dash choke, that's a lot of guys with. I thought, it's not worth the energy. And then when my guy told me there was a minute left, I told everyone, I'm taking this guy in 1 minute. I don't care whether it's punches or whether it be the grappling. I'm taking the guy at 1 minute. So when he said, oh, 1 minute left, I mean, one round, when he said 1 minute left, I was like, right, that's it. I got it. You know what? It means everything to me. I mean, the last fight when I fought in the tournament was main card, and I've been telling my guys, like, I'm a main card fighter, I'm a high level guy. A lot of my guys that tune in, they're all watching the Channel 5 and they're like, why are you not on Channel 5, this and that? At the start of the week, I wasn't even supposed to be on Channel 5, and then it's manifested in some way, and I've ended up kind of co-main, if you will, under Congo on one of the big, on the first MMA card in France, and I feel like this is where I needed to be. And I can showcase to all of my UK fans what I'm capable of, and feel like this is going to be me that tooth I need to become a world champion, which I have no doubt in my mind that I will be world champion.
Dano?
Hey, so congratulations. A great performance on this first round victory for yourself. You said in the cage afterwards you would like to be an alternate for the featherweight tournament that's now ongoing. Do you think that's realistic considering you were eliminated already?
You know what? If you watch my fight with Vital, I mean, it wasn't the most exciting fight in the world, but it was a close decision loss. I mean, I was having my way until I got blocked with one shot at the end of the first that kind of swayed that decision. I beat him up for the 4 minutes, 50 seconds in the first round, got rocked, he stole the round. Second round I won, third round it was back and forth, and he stole it. The other guys who've been knocked out of that tournament, they've been battered, submitted, or dominated, you know what I'm saying? I dominated my first guy on Bellator, I've had a run on the European circuit before that, I lost a close decision, lost then, just strangled my guy now in the first round. I've showed my level, I don't really see many guys in that tournament that deserve the place over me, you know, but if I've got to wait, I'm more than happy to wait. Like I said, I'm a fighter. I believe my talent, sometimes I might need knocking down if I get cheated. For me, I already see myself with the champ, because that means I've got to sit back, win another 2-3 fights before I get the belt, so be it. But if I'm shouting out there and saying, I want to be the ultimate, I want to be in there, and I want to kind of smash and take the opportunity and spot you versus the brave, would you not agree?
Oh no, absolutely. And also, you know, like you said, the featherweight division, regardless whether you get in or not, it's kind of tied up for the moment. The champion could, in theory, have 3 more fights that are already determined. Would you consider maybe, I know that lightweight, he's the same champion, so it would be equally as tied up, but would you consider going up or going down or jumping around weight division?
Lightweight, 100%. And you know what, if that comes there, I've already manifested that stuff as well. I was telling my boy when I was cutting weight this last fight, I was like, you know what, I can be featherweight, but lightweight, I'd shine at that weight too. I'm not a small guy, you know, I walk around big, and I spar with feather, I fight spar with lightweight, I spar with welterweight. All these guys, and they don't outstrength me. I mean, you put me against someone my size, a featherweight, and I usually dominate and start to finish. So, if you put that belt on the line at lightweight, sign me up, I'm there.
Seven.
Hey, Shaw, congrats on the win once again. You know, like you said, you know, there's a bit of a delay when it comes to where the featherweight division is going. Do you look on rebooking the fight with Robert Whitford, or do you look somewhere else if you're looking for another fight?
You know what? Whitford's done now. For me, in my opinion, Whitford's done. I'll give you a couple of reasons why. When my opponent pulled out, before I was in Bellator, he talked all the talk. If I win my fight, I'll fight Saul Rogers, I'll do this, I'll do that. Okay, fine. My manager said, all right, you're going to fight Whitford. That fight came about, he won his fight, like he said, yeah, I'll fight him, kept me waiting, didn't end up taking the fight. Then we got booked for March, good, let's go, I'll take the fight. We didn't end up happening with all the stuff that's gone on. Then we got rebooked for now, this one, and it didn't happen. And I'm saying, nah, 3 chances, you kind of had your chance for now. For me, I'm looking past Whitford, but I want the guys in the tournament, or the guys who are getting knocked out the tournament, because I consider them the best guys in the division, and I feel like they're going to be my closest way to getting the belt.
Alright, another question for me is, are you just restricted to fighting in Europe, or is it possible for you to go to the States to fight?
Yeah, you know what, I've usually got my P1 working visa, I spend a lot of time over at Stanford MMA training for fights over there, but with all this COVID and stuff like that, I've been linked to the UK, I'm in the process of renewing my visa now. I just wanted to get the fight out of the way, get my visa renewed and go. So yeah, in the next couple of weeks I'll have my visa back renewed and I can fight wherever Bellator want to put me.
Hi, coming off a loss after a year out, how does it feel to get the win in the way you have, and in a such important stage like this?
You know what, they need to be calm again backstage there, and I know some people just think this doesn't mean much, but for me this is everything. I've sacrificed my life for this game, you know, and losing that last fight in that tournament, that meant everything to me. And being given this opportunity on the card of this magnitude, you know, the first historic MMA event in Paris, it means a lot. So, you know, if I chilled in inside, I'm kind of bursting with pride, and that was, there's a whole mix of emotions, beating the guy, beating kind of fifth round, being back in the winning column, being on this card, and you know, my name getting thrown back in the mix and being where I belong.
You were the coming event, now you are 2-1 in Bellator. How far do you feel the title set?
We'll take a few more. Lenny, go ahead.
How so? Saul Rogers, how's it going? I can't get my words together.
I'm going to Saul.
Saul, yep.
Saul.
Yeah, how?
Vanessa, my brother, Saul.
So, I'm even English, and I still can't pronounce that.
Oh, you know what? You sound like my boy Tuco. You're a southerner, you 100%.
Yeah, I am. I'm from London, yes.
I'll let you
off. So, a lot of guys from Manchester are breaking through the MMA scene right now. You've got Kane Musa at Manchester Top Team, and also Lerone Murphy in UFC. They're making waves. And we've got you at SBG Manchester, you know, you're making through at Bellator. And what's the possibility of you pitching the idea to Bellator executive, Bellator Europe executive, Dave Green, to maybe make Bellator come to Manchester, and maybe you headline the show, or maybe Kane Musa?
You know what's crazy you say that? Me and my boy was talking about that, saying Bellator's never done a show in Manchester
before. I'm not too sure off the top of my head.
No, we've never done a show in Manchester, and I truly believe, I mean, Lerone in UFC, and then it's a toss-up between me and Kane, but Kane's a good mate of mine, but Kane, you can be coming, no way Kane's made it over me, but yeah, put a show on in Manchester, we'll bring a big crowd, our main event, my boy Kane can be co-main event, and that's it, 100%, you know, I need to teach you about that, because I'm telling you, I'm going to get 100% about that.
It would have to be, I think, so Bellator Europe executive David Green, because he does the European series and stuff like that.
Well, you know what? Would you not agree Bellator needs to come to Manchester?
It would be huge.
That's the next step. Me and you were going to manifest that one.
So my last question is, so after you got back in track today, what did you learn from your last fight and the loss?
You know what? What I learned from that loss was mindset. In this game, mindset is everything. Your mind can be your best friend or your worst enemy. It's how you control it. You know, when I fought Baicho, my mind wasn't good. You know, I wasn't in a great place. But like, and again, I'm not coming out saying, oh, I think that was this, I was that. It was 100% me. I had the absolute best camp I could have asked for. But just sometimes in this game, if your mind's not there, you're not going to perform. So that was my biggest thing from that. Kind of look yourself in the mirror and thought, what do you really want? Do you want to do this? Do you want to be world champion? I thought, sat down and thought, you know what? I really do. I want to be world champion. I believe in my skill set, and that's what I'm carrying forward now. That's why I'm tuning for these titles, because in the past, I said it because that's what was expected from me. But this is the first time that in my life I truly feel it in my heart and soul that I want to be and I'm going to be world champion.
Rick Sanchez?
Yeah, congratulations on the fight.
My question is, now you want, now from a year off, and now you want this fight, do you have any other fighters personally you want to face that's like been too much personal?
You know what? I mean, inside the cage, it's all been against the catch line there, but outside of the cage now, I don't kind of take that animosity to no one. And for me personally, I don't really have any guys who are kind of trying to take it to me, so I couldn't sit there and say, right, I've got a personal vendetta against this guy, or I've got a vendetta against this guy. I just kind of, not to be corny or cliche, but it's not, I don't want to fight with Bellator want to give me, I want to fight the number one contenders, you get what I mean? So, whoever loses that title shot, whoever Bellator is thinking, or this is the next guy we're thinking, like, I want to fight them guys, and that's the way I'm going to work my way up to the belt, and that's it. So, if they're calling any names out, I want to fight whoever Bellator are telling me are the number one contenders, the top five in the division, you know what I'm saying?
Thank you very much for your time, Saul. Congratulations.